Greetings. It's a rather simple proof, really. Islam is submission to blah, the deity of Islam. And who defines who the deity of Islam is? The Quran, silly. The Quran defines the religion called Islam. The religion of submission to, well, whoever the Quran says. And who does the Quran say to submit to? The Quran teaches this two ways. The first is the simple and meaningless conceptual way. The Quran says, submit to Allah. The second is the functional, pragmatic, and actual way. You obey who the Quran tells you to obey. The first is simple, and the Quran says many times, submit to Allah, or he who submits to Allah. Surah 39:54, turn to your Lord, submit to him, before the punishment overtakes you, and you can no longer be helped. You'll find verses like that all over the Quran. But if you're awake, you'll also screw up your face with WTF when you come across this ayat. Surah 465. But no, by thy Lord, they will not believe until they make thee a judge in what they disagreed about between them. Again, they find within themselves no impediment to what thou hast decided, resigning themselves to submission, full submission. This is the Lale Bakhtiar translation. But no, by thy Lord. So someone is talking here. Mohammed, Allah, someone else. We don't know. By thy Lord is swearing an oath. Swearing by Allah is not defined as shirk, so this would not be shirk, regardless of who is speaking. But I always find it disturbing, this claimed voice of Allah talking about himself as separate from himself, as another beside himself. Never by me, or I am Allah. More like Muhammad acting as if he were Allah, but afraid to use a consistent voice. They will not believe. Talking about someone else. From will not believe means they do not believe. That would mean this voice is talking about unbelievers. Make sense so far? They will not believe until they make thee a judge in what they disagreed between them. And here it gets interesting in a what the kind of way. Make thee a judge. Thee must mean Muhammad. So now we have established these unbelievers will only believe, will only be believers when they make Muhammad their judge. Again, they find within themselves no impediment to what thou hadst decided, what thou hast decided, what you, Muhammad, have decided. Resigning themselves to submission, full submission. Resigning themselves to submission, full submission. Resigning themselves to submission to Muhammad, to full submission to Muhammad, to Muhammad's decisions. Beep, beep, back up the truck. I'm going to paraphrase this so you can see the real problem. But no, by thy Lord, they will not believe, meaning they will not be believers, until they resign themselves to submission to Muhammad. Full submission to Muhammad. The Quran says you are not a believer unless you submit to Muhammad. And I thought Islam meant submission to Allah. Remember, I said this was a simple proof. The Quran commands you to submit to the deity of Islam. And then we find the Quran commands you to submit to Muhammad. The Quran says you are not a believer unless you submit to Muhammad. Make no mistake, the Quran also commands you to submit to your Lord, thy sustainer, aka Allah. but it also chains Allah to Muhammad as a partner. Submitting to Allah is not enough. Obeying the thing you think is Allah is simply not enough, according to the Quran. Submitting to Muhammad is required, and that means Muhammad is one of the two Allahs of Islam. Obeying the thing you think is Allah is simply not enough, according to the Quran. And therefore, Islam means submission to Muhammad and Allah. If you disagree, O Mohammedan, produce surah and ayat that says, obey Allah alone. It is very simple. Produce surah and ayat that says, obey Allah alone. Not worship, obey. Otherwise, accept the pagan teaching of the Quran and recognize Muhammad, the partner of Allah, the second God of Islam. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.